Hello students, welcome to Royal Chem Chemistry class. So today we are going to continue again with our oxidation reagents. So last class we were discussing about the oxidation of alcohol. In there we were discussing about the chromium based oxidation, then manganese based oxidation. So today we are going to discuss about the oxidation of alkene. So basically the oxidation of alkene is categorized into three parts. The first one is epoxidation reaction. The second one is dipole formation. Dipole formation is basically two hydroxyl group. This will be called as dipole. So dipole formation, this kind of reagent you may observe in many times in organic chemistry. That is in pinnacle reagent, pinnacle oxidation reaction, rearrangement reaction, you have observed a dipole. So this dipole formation is basically nothing, it can be created from the oxidation of alcohol. And the last one is oxidative cleavage. Okay, alkene is oxidatively cleavage into some product. So these are the main three category in which oxidation of alkene can be classified. Now let us discuss about the epoxidation of alkene. So epoxidation of alkene, so I have taken for the epoxidation purpose, we have substrate as our alkene. And the important reagent used for the epoxidation of alkene, that MCPBA, is known as metachloroperbenzoic acid. This is the structure for the MCPBA. So what happens that the reaction is that if you have alkene and if you add the MCPBA, it will epoxidize into this form. This is known as epoxide. Okay. So now let us look into the mechanistic part of this reaction. Basically what happens is that we know that alkene is an electron rich system. 5 electrons is a highly electron rich system. So it can act as a nucleophilic center. Okay, generally in organic chemistry, electron rich system or electron excess system, we call it as nucleophilic center. And we have MCPBA. If you look at the MCPBA, this oxygen is highly electron deficient center. Why? Because it is adjacent to this oxygen. So two oxygen adjacent to each other, it will create in this oxygen a highly electron deficiency. So what will happen that if it is electron deficient species, this oxygen is known as electron deficient species, so it can act as an electrophilic center. So what will happen that the pi electron system of this alkene will react on the oxygen, this oxygen electrophilic center, and simultaneously this bond will break. Why this bond will break? Because we are getting a good leaving group, benzoylate anion. So simultaneously when this alkene will attack on this oxygen, so definitely one positive charge will be generated on this carbon. So in order to reduce that positive charge, the lone pair of the oxygen also again react into this. This kind of mechanism we already seen the bromination reaction, addition reaction, bromination. So we will get a transition state like this. This is like a transition state you will get, where you can see that the double bond is breaking. Then oxygen is forming with one bond with this carbon and another carbon, and simultaneously this bond is breaking. And this hydrogen also breaker, this can be, this hydrogen is abstracted by finally this oxygen. So this kind of transition state will get. So after that finally we will get a product like epoxidation and byproduct as this benzoic acid. So this is the mechanistic part of the epoxidation reaction. We see MCPB as a reagent. Okay. Now let us discuss about some of the important points regarding the epoxidation reaction. So that means, we know that epoxidation reaction is a syn addition reaction. That means it will, the MCPB reagent will attack on the alkene on the same position of the alkene, that means syn addition. And secondly, we know that this reaction in which alkene acts as electron rich species, that means nucleophilic center. So if you have more electron rich alkene, then reaction will be faster. That means if you have your alkene is highly electron rich, so it can easily react with the MCPBA. And third point is that if hydrogen body assistant group present in the reactant, then reaction can be faster in nature due to transition state stability. That means let's say if you have an OH group which is a hydrogen bonding tendency group, if it's present in your substrate, then during transition state this OH group can make a hydrogen bonding with your MCPBA oxygen. Hence, it will stabilize the transition state. As a result, reaction rate will be faster. So these are the three points you have to remember when you are dealing with the epoxidation reaction. Okay, now let us discuss about some of the example based on the epoxy resin. So in first example, it is given that the substrate treated with the MCBBA. So if you look at the substrate, you have two alkene. This one is first alkene, this one second alkene. And we have already discussed that, in discussing about the important point about the epoxy resin. Richer the alkene, if your alkene is more rich, then it will react faster. So among these two double bond, you know that this alkene is more rich because of this CH3 group. It will understood, it will create more electron loss due to hyperpolarization. So how you should identify that whether alkene is rich or not based on your GOC, general organic chemistry concept. So you know that the more substituted alkene is more electron rich because of hyperpolarization. So definitely this alkene will epoxidize. So you get this product. In second example also you have two alkene. So definitely this alkene is attached to a carbon group which is an electron withdrawing group. So electron density of this oxygen, this alkene will be reduced. So MCBBA then definitely react on this alkene. So this you will get correspondingly this epoxide. In third case also you have two alkene in which one alkene is attached to CH3, another one is OMe. So you know that the OMe uses a plus M effect, plus mesomer effect. So due to plus M effect, it will increase the electron density of this alkene. Similarly, CH3 also another is a plus I group, and also it will show hyperpolarization. That also increase the electron density of this pi electron system. But among the plus I effect and hyperpolarization, the mesomer effect will be dominant. You know that from your general organic chemistry concept that mesomeric effect is always dominant. So that means this alkene will be richer in nature, so that MCBBA will react on this alkene, so you will get this product. This kind of question, this third exam asked in previous year exam, gate exam. Okay. So these are the example based on the MCBBA oxidation. Okay. Now let us discuss about some of the stereochemistry aspect of the epoxidation reaction. So the first example, so you are given the substance and treated with the MCBBA. So what kind of product you will get? So the product I already given that you will get this product. Now you can have another product also where you can have also another product where your epoxy is down the plane. But predominantly the specifically we are getting this product. Why? The reason is that I already pointed in important point that if you have a hydrogen bonding forming group, bond forming group in your substrate, then reaction rate will be more stable because hydrogen bond will make in a transition state, hydrogen bond will form. So that transition state will be more stable, as a result reaction rate will faster. That we are already discussed in important point, third point. So similarly, if you look at the substrate, we have OH group, it will undergo, it will assist for hydrogen bonding. But since this OH group is above the plane, so definitely the MCBBA will attack on the alkene from above the plane only. Why? Because to get hydrogen bond stability. So if it attack on the above the plane, so your epoxide will be also above the plane, because in above the plane only it will get a hydrogen bond stability due to this OH group. So you won't get this product. But let's say if you take the another structure, second example, that if you in case of hydrogen OH group, if you are acetate group, then reaction with MCBBA, then you will get predominantly the epoxide below the plane. Why? Because OAC group won't give any hydrogen bonding. So then what will happen, that MCBBA will react below the plane of the alkene because of steric hindrance. If any chance of hydrogen bonding is there, then only it will MCBBA will react on the same face of the hydrogen bonding group. If there is no hydrogen bonding, then reaction will go completely under the influence of the steric effect. So OAC is bulkier group. So if it coming above the plane, then it will steric hindrance will be there. So MCBBA will attack on the below the plane of the alkene, so will get this product. Similarly, if you take CH3, so above the plane, you are treating with MCBBA, again epoxidation will occur below the plane because of steric consideration, steric hindrance. So if your hydrogen bonding system is there, if your hydrogen bonding is there in your substrate, so then epoxidation will occur the your hydrogen bond based on the stereochemistry of the hydrogen bonding group. Okay. Okay. Now the drawback behind there is some drawback behind the epoxidation of oxidation. Because let's say if you have in a substrate you have alkene and a ketone group, you know that your Naimann reaction MCPBA will also undergo some other kind of a reaction if you have ketone group present in your substrate. That is nothing but Bayer-Villiger oxidation. That means if you have ketone and then you have MCPBA, so definitely Bayer-Villiger oxidation will occur. That means you know that in Bayer-Villiger oxidation you are getting ketone will convert into ester group. So you get a competition between an alkene and ester ketone group while treating with the MCPBA. So this is one of the drawback of the MCPBA oxidation. Then you may think that then how I'll get this product. Let's say if I have ketone also, even if I have ketone and alkene, then how I specifically epoxidize the alkene into epoxide. For that, the solution is that you treat with the H2O2 instead of MCPBA. H2O2 is an electron-rich peroxide. So it can easily undergo epoxidation in case of alpha, beta unsaturated compound having carbon group. Okay. So this problem you can be avoid when using H2O2 as a your substrate reagent. Okay. Now let us discuss about some of the difference between the MCPB and H2O2, where we can use H2O2 and what case we can use H2O2 and MCPBA. Okay. So MCPBA, we know that it's electrophilic in nature. Why? Because the oxygen attached to MCPBA, peroxide linkage oxygen, high electron deficient because of the acyl group, benzyl group present on the MCPBA. And comparatively, H2O2 is nucleophilic in nature, and compared to MCPBA, H2O2 is nucleophilic in nature. Since MCPBA is an electrophilic in nature, electron deficient species, so it will always prefer the more richer alkene, react with the more richer alkene. That means it will react with the electron rich alkene. But H2O2, we already told that compared to MCPBA, it is electron rich nature. Compared to H2O2, compared to MCPBA, it is electron rich species. And MCPBA, you know that, what MCPBA is? This is MCPBA. Because of this acyl group, this oxygen is highly electron deficient nature. But this O group is not that much electron deficient nature. This is comparatively electron rich with the MCPBA. So what will happen then? If you have electron deficient alkene, since it is a nucleophilic in nature, so it will react specifically with the electron deficient alkene. So what kind of electron deficient species we have? This alpha beta unsaturated compound like this one and this one. If you have this kind of system alkene, then H2O2 is a preferable nature. So this also can be asked in exam, where you can use MCPBA, where you can H2O2 for doing epoxidation reaction. If you see MCPBA here, definitely what will happen that it will undergo Bayer-Villiger oxidation because ketone group is there. So there is a competition between Bayer-Villiger oxidation and epoxidation. So we cannot use MCPBA, we have to use H2O2. So this differentiation you have to understand. Okay, now let us discuss about some of the previous year exam question based on the MCPBA reaction. So the question given that the major product found in the following reaction sequence is, you have given this substrate, and first step is reaction of lithium with the liquid ammonia and tertiary putting as a solvent, and second step is MCPBA. So this question asked in CSER June 2012 4 mark question. So this is a very simple question. So you look at the first step. We have already discussed that first step. This is Birch reduction. In Birch reduction, you know that if you have electron donating group present, then it will form double bond adjacent to electron donating group. So in first step, we will get a Birch reduction. If you have electron donating group present in Birch reduction, what will happen then? That double bond will form the adjacent to electron donating group. We have already discussed in Birch reduction. So this will get your first step product in first step. In second step, we have MCPBA. That we have already discussed that MCPBA reaction. The important point we have already discussed that in MCPBA, more electron rich alkene will be more reactive. So you know that among these two alkene, OME attached alkene is more electron rich because of the plus M effect of OME. So definitely epoxidation will occur on the this oxygen, this alkene. So we will get OMe here, epoxide here, you get this. So if you look at the answer, the option you will get C is your correct answer. Very simple question. So sometimes instead of NCPBr, you can also get another reagent, that is CF3COOH. This also a trifluoroacetic acid. This also act as a epoxidation reagent, just like MCPB. This also electron deficient MCPB, electron deficient benzoic acid. This is per acetic acid. So this kind of reagent also used sometimes instead of MCPB. So this all about the MCPB epoxidation reaction and H2O2 epoxidation reaction. Okay. Now next lecture we will discuss about the other kind of oxidation of alkene. Okay. Thank you for watching Royal Chemistry classes. Keep learning with Royal Chem.